Brody. I recorded this while ago and then found out I didn't have any audio about halfway through. So I ditched an entire segment on the 3D end of making the tattoo. There was a major problem over there, but I just started using Photoshop 2020, and there's some new stuff in this. I was thrilled. It's kind of like Christmas for me. And I'm making nurse tattoos for an event that I have coming up, and I'm going to give them away during the event, and then after that they're going in the shop. And I have no idea what I was originally saying in this video, so I'm trying to do a voiceover without even knowing what I'm doing. So there's a lot of nothing going on for quite a while I was blabbing. So I guess I could blab some more. Not sure what point I started actually working. So, with that having been said, one of the new features was this, select subject, wherein the AI of Photoshop makes a decision as to what your subject matter is. And you can cut something out of the background real easy, like this right here. I just click the button, and then I have to wait for a second usually, and then it makes the selection. So I see that it cut off the top of her hat and added in some stuff down the bottom I don't need, but we can fix that. And so I went ahead and made a layer mask, I believe, right here. And that got rid of some stuff. I'm having an issue right now with the program not letting me paint on my layer mask. You have to click on your layer mask to do this editing, and you will need a white paintbrush to make things that you accidentally didn't get to show by painting white on your layer mask. If you didn't know these things. But I don't know why black isn't working for me to hide. Don't know what's going on with that today. So I didn't fortunately need that. So yeah, I brought back the corners of her hat because they were cut off, and I was trying to find out what I might have accidentally left out. So I did a bunch of experimental painting around the edges to try and see if there was anything else that would turn up if I did that right. And then, what else? I just kept, you know, digging at it. As I said, and I was talking to myself, as usual. But, you know, bored out of my mind. So it all looked okay for a bit there. I did some other adjustments to her. Like down in here, all the extra stuff that was selected. I have to fix that as a smart object later on. And this is where I was trying to show that, yeah, my black isn't working to hide things again, so to heck with it, I'll fix it as a smart object. White worked to show, but black wasn't working to hide, and I'm not sure why. And it was actually on the default black. No idea what was going on. This just started happening to me today. So I convert it to a smart object, and then I rasterize the layer. Now you can do whatever to it. And I've got it on a soft brush, and I come in here and painted out that extra bit down at the bottom and kind of left it like, you know, how tattoos are faded out around the edges nowadays.
You have another fucking whip message.
whip stuff. And then straightened up what I had accidentally added in a little bit more than I should have. This is just going on and on as I edit this silly thing. Then I switch to the magic eraser and instantly get rid of those little gaps between her arms, which is really handy. Gee, I wonder what I could have been talking about. For all I know, I could have been looking at my cell phone. Speaking of which, oh Lord. Oh, what was that? Yeah, I can't. Every time I try to move my inky forward, I can't do it. Okay. So, I went on about skin tones here, and how you need to make sure that it's going to look good both on dark and light skins. And this is not easy. This was me taking a sample of actual dark skin with the eyedropper tool, and that's what I came up with. So that is an actual sample of the right color. It doesn't look anything like skin now, though. So it just gives me an idea of anything that might be hanging out. It is white outlines around the edges and things like that. You don't want it. And these things will just look like stickers when you stick them on. See those white outlines? Everybody's been coming on my tattoo tutorial complaining about how they get in white outlines. This part will definitely solve that. So, I'm showing what it looks like on lighter skin, and I've used the eyedropper tool to actually sample from a skin in Second Life, which doesn't look like skin right now, like I said. Then, real quick here, I make an adjustment layer on that and change it to multiply. It darkens up the whole thing quite a bit. You can mess with the opacity on these things if you think that they need it for being too dark. I think I would kind of just tone it down a hair, maybe. Then I tried to see what it looked like on dark skin, and that's really, as I said, true to life looking to me. If you ever watch any of the Ink Master shows or whatever, I used to have, my first husband was a tattoo artist, which is how I come about all this. Okay, there's some dots down here, and I tried to fix it with a smudge tool, which I thought was really not so good. And because I was smearing it too much. I undid that and I used the healing brush, I think. Yeah, now you can go undo in Photoshop 2020, and you never used to be able to do that. So it's just like GIMP now. I decided to use this healing brush, and it's undarkened, so it's just gonna fix those little specks. And then I seen something over there look like a mole, but I didn't know if it was on the person or on the drawing. So I changed that to lighten up there and get rid of that speck. And then I was messing around with something else and I couldn't tell if it was, I said, have you ever been farting around with something in one of these programs and try to get rid of something over and over and over again to come to find out it's just a speck on your screen? That happens to me too much, probably. So that's what I was doing there. It's driving me nuts that I can't forward the video while I'm talking. I didn't know that. Learn something new every day. I'm in Filmora doing this talky bit right here. So, not exactly sure why I was fooling with the hat again, but okay. Cleaning up my edges best I can. It hopefully doesn't look as pixelated as it does to me here. The edges. Yeah, it looked really bad in the 3D thing. So, there's something I have done wrong. My document probably wasn't big enough before I started. Cut out some of this black around her finger without it making it look unnatural, because the rest of it shaded around the bottom. And eventually I think I decided to leave way more of it.
You have another fucking text message.
My goodness, my phone's going crazy. In the heck? Okay. So with all that done, I'm testing it on the dark skin again, and I'm testing it on everything. So you want to turn off those mock-up skins when you get ready to save it, and save it as a PNG. And here in a sec, I will show a couple of the others really quick that I have done for this conglomeration. And that's all I was gonna say, right? Okay, so that was saved. And here's nurse three, nurse two, I don't know, one of the nurses. She's probably not going to look very good on dark skin because of the hair being so colorful. I don't know. And if you're shoving a whole bunch of tattoos together, it's likely that at least one of them is going to turn up weird looking. I did a standing pinup. Well, that about wraps it up in here for this one. So basically what we're doing is trying to get rid of the white around the outside and making them look good on all skin tones by getting all the light tones out of there using Multiply. I hope that helps somebody. And if I did, then like and subscribe and buy me a cup of coffee if you feel inclined. Thank you.